of your, the faith we sing this morning. Our God is an awesome God. We dedicate this hour of worship to you, Father, as we praise you and glorify your name through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Okay, now we'll begin on page 170. Oh, how I love Jesus. We'll be talking about love and faith and joy this morning.
Turn again, O God of hosts, look down from heaven and see.
Amen.
But let your hand be upon those of your right hand, the ones whom you have made strong for yourself.
Then we will never turn back from you. Give us life, and we will call on your name.
Restore us, O Lord, O God. Let your face shine, that we may be saved.
Lord, be with us now as we serve you with our tithe and our offering. Take these, Lord, and bless them as you see need. In your name we ask, amen.
The resurrection of body and the life everlasting. Amen.
hearts, the Parker family, and they move forward without Mr. Bowden. And I know that we want to, I couldn't put it in print, but it was mentioned, the young man that passed away this past week with cancer. What was his name again?
Brandon Coleman.
Brandon Coleman. We need to be in prayer for his family. He was 23 years old and put up a very courageous fight, but it went very quickly. So he now rests in the arms of our Lord. I know that we have a number of people. Roger Smith is still recuperating. The last word we got to him was he's doing well. He has neighbors that are helping him out. Miss Inez is doing better. She is still in rehab, but she's getting a little stronger each day, so we need to keep her in our prayers and in our thoughts. Are there any others that I've missed?
No, this morning we had to actually take Buddy to the hospital last night. So she's there at the hospital with me, but I don't know which hospital, because she just told me that they were at the hospital.
Okay. And that's the one that.
Just got moved to nursing home.
Oh, okay. Dee Payne's brother. He's been in a nursing home and they have had to take him to the hospital this morning. He's had some very serious health issues, so let's be in prayer for that family as Dee Marie has to make some very serious decisions on his behalf. So I think she's the only one, isn't she? He doesn't have any children, I don't believe, so she's in this pretty much on her own, so let's keep her in prayers. Any others? I have to say, and I know they're not our church, but I was at Rexford this morning, and they had a praise lifted up for the most, I kid you not, beautiful baby girl I've ever seen. And I understand this couple went through a lot to have this baby, and so she was at church. I got to see her before baby did, and yes, I texted him and rubbed that in. But let's send up a prayer of thanksgiving to the Lord for that great blessing.
Sunday, so hopefully we will be familiar to you, but the thing about this
the song is, we have more than 10,000 reasons for our song to sing for Jesus Christ in our lives. For you, Chloe. Who shut the mouths of lions, quenched the fury of the flames,
and escaped the edge of the sword. His weakness was turned to strength, and he became powerful in battle and routed foreign armies. This is the word of God for the people of God. Let the people say,
thanks be to God.
Okay, I'm going to start off giving you some definitions, and then we're going to go into some of this analogy. Faith is defined as belief with strong conviction, firm belief in something for which there may be no tangible proof, complete trust, confidence, reliance, or devotion. Faith is the opposite of doubt. Webster's New World College Dictionary defines faith as unquestioning belief that does not require proof or evidence. Unquestioning belief in God, religious tenets. In our day-to-day lives, we as Christians are assailed with doubts. And to be honest, I believe the ones who are non-Christian are assailed with doubts. What is happening? Where are we going? What's going to happen next? There's always those doubts. Thomas was one of the biggest doubters, and bless him, the most famous doubter in the Bible. On the other side of this coin, in Hebrews chapter 11, the Bible introduces an impressive list of heroic believers from the Old Testament in a passage, and I've never heard this before, often called the Faith Hall of Fame. These men and women and their stories stand out to encourage and challenge our faith. For believers, faith starts a chain of events that ultimately leads to heaven. By faith, through God's grace, Christians are forgiven. We receive the gift of salvation by faith in the sacrifice of Jesus Christ. By trusting wholly in God, through faith in Jesus Christ, believers are saved from God's judgment of sin and its consequences. Finally, by God's grace, we go on to become heroes of faith by becoming by following the Lord into greater adventures through Him and in Him. Love. This is a Webster definition. A feeling of strong attachment induced by that which delights or commands admiration. Preeminent kindness or devotion to another. Affection, tenderness. Example, the love of brothers and sisters. Affection, kind feeling, friendship, strong liking or desire, fondness, goodwill, opposed to hate, often with an object, due to gratitude and reverence to God. I think we would all agree with that one. You have to have God to love, to truly love. Now I have my own definition of love. Whenever you look at your children, when you look at your parents, when you look at your siblings, your nieces, your nephews, your grandfather, everybody in your world, your friends, what do you feel for them? Love. It's a very strong emotion. It is overwhelming. It is overpowering. It is that strong within us. Can you imagine God's love that He has given to us over the years, over the centuries, and that love that's promised in the future and moving forward? Overwhelming, unimaginable, just extreme. Hope. A desire of some good accompanied with an expectation of obtaining it, or a belief that it is obtainable. An exception of something which is thought to be desirable. Confidence, pleasing expectancy. Tumbling today. Hope, one of the three Christian virtues. Hope, expect, and wish. Hope is to be optimistic. Hope is to intend with some possibility of fulfillment. Now, hearing these definitions, they each have one thing in common for us as Christians, and that is we have to have all of them to be what God calls us to be. Now, some of the things that we don't always think about is, and I find myself in the same situation, is with God's, with my faith in God, with my hope in what God can do for me and through me, and in my in-depth love for Him and His love for me, we sometimes forget that our strength is in Him. Not in us, it's in Him. We sometimes forget that God is with us in our darkest times. His love is with us in our darkest times. And so is His hope for us. Now, I'm going to get away from that, and I'm going to go into the nostalgia, because I'm not going to keep this here all day and just to go on forever. When I was reading over this scripture, when I read the whole thing, I just about, I'll be honest, freaked out. I was like, oh my gosh, no, I cannot do that. But when I finally got myself settled down and took scripture by scripture, you know, verse by verse, and decided, okay, what is the Lord telling me? What is He wanting me to do? This is what I came up with in my mind, and it's been popping ever since. Last night, I got up at 4 o'clock this morning with it still popping through my head. And that's personal examples of faith, hope, and love. Now I'm going to begin with, and I hope Marla and Sammy will be upset with me. Sammy and I were talking the other day about his new grandson on the way. And he shared with me that Ainsley Kate, from the time she was 3, and understood, started praying for a brother or a sister. She would pray every night. She would pray every morning. She would pray when she did the blessing. Anytime there was prayer, she prayed for a brother or a sister. Now, Auntie Clayton is 10. For 7 years, that child has kept her faith, her love, and her hope alive. 7 years. She never gave up. And now God is rewarding her with a baby brother. Now, once it gets here, she may change her mind on that. Right now, she is excited. Okay? So He answers our prayers. It's not in our time. It's in His. And the blessings we receive are many. Another person I follow is Richard Harris. We all know Richard. Most of us do. He went through a lot. But one thing he never lost was his faith. He never lost his hope, and he never lost his love for everybody he knew, and he never lost his love in God. He knew that he was going to be leaving sooner than he wanted to. God blessed him, he said this, with the opportunity to have 2 good years of quality life with those he wanted to spend it with. He had no regrets when he left this world. He had faith. He knew he was going to be in the arms of God and would have no more suffering. He had hope that God was going to watch over his family and his friends that he was leaving behind. He had love abundant because he knew how much he loved a lot of people and how much they loved him and would share that love and continue that love for his family. So he was at peace. He had comfort, no regrets. How many of us can say that today? He was an inspiration to those who, he didn't know he was inspiring, but he did. And he continues to be one for each of us, me especially, when I think of things or when I need something to reach for in comfort and in peace. Think of my grandmother. I've talked to y'all a lot about her memaw. She was a memaw, a southern memaw what she suffered through, losing two husbands, raising three kids. And in a time where it was hard, but she never lost her faith. She never lost her hope, and she never lost her love that she had in God and others. I can remember her and him going through her meals with her, and he would say, "Mama, there's not enough meals to pay 10% this month. You'll have to do five." And she would say, "Don, that won't do. You're going to do my 10% first, and then you pay my bills. If I can't pay them all, I'll pay part of them. But that goes first." And time and time, this was almost every month. And Daddy would sit down, and he'd do the 10%, because she'd sit there and watch him. And until that was taken out, he didn't write another check. And then he'd pay the rest of the bill. And she might not have the 10 cents left in that checking account, but she paid them all. And it took him many years to figure out if we just have the faith and the hope and the love. That's how it works. That's how it works. And the sicker she got, the more love she gave, the more faith she showed me, and the more hope she gave me that I could be a happy person she was and be as godly as she was for the rest of my life. When people we love die, whether it's peaceful or whether it's through suffering, we ache and we hurt. And we think there's no greater pain than what we're suffering at the time. And that's when, if that person is a Christian, we have to look at the faith that person had. We have to look at our own faith. Our faith tells us that that person is now with the Lord. No pain, no suffering, and a whole lot better place than we are. And we have to remember that that love that God shows for that person and bringing them home to Him is the same love He sends to us if we will just open our arms and feel the embrace. And that hope is given to us through the Lord at that embrace. The hope that I can live another day, that I can do what I need to do. You'll always miss that person. That hole will never be filled. But just think of it this way. Where that hole is, you have the hope, the faith, and the love that will never leave you for that person. You'll always have it. You'll always feel it. And you can always reach in and take it out when you need it. That is what God gives us through hope, love, and faith. When children are born, oh, how grand is that? At Rexford, I think I said it earlier, they had this, I mean, this world was beautiful. You know, all babies are beautiful, but this baby was beautiful. And her parents prayed for her and went through a lot to get her. And she's here, and she is a gift, and she is a blessing. And that whole church, myself included, I got wrapped up in it, has so much faith and hope and love for her. And she's only 8 weeks old. So why can we not have hope and faith and love in each other and in those around us? It's a hard thing to step out of those boxes. It's a hard thing to extend a hand or to give a smile. And in today's world, it's hard, period. There are so many crazies. There are so many people that, you know, you think, oh, they're nice. And then the next thing you know, oh my, I'm not so nice, you know. And it's hard to know what to do. And the only thing we can do is rely on the love and the faith and the hope that we have in God. That He's going to guide us. That He's going to give us that push. And we accept it. And we push through it. There's so much more I could talk about on this subject. And there's so much more I'm going to say. But I'm not going to do that. We'll make it short and sweet today. And just tell everybody, this week, try one thing. Leave
Lord's feet. Let him lead you, guide you, and show you what you need to do and how you need to do it. Amen.
Thank you, God, for allowing the Holy Spirit to speak through you, to us through you. And in this day and time, we can all use a little more faith, a little more hope, a whole lot of hope. Let's stand as we sing our closing song this morning on page 452, My Faith Looks Up to Thee.
Love, hope, and joy. Amen.